What does it say?
Do you now know Morse code?
I know all kind of shit.
Sure.
What were you writing on that day?
He was doing a smiley face.
It's not letters. It's just numbers.
Just thinking, like, how the numbers were going to look like was a huge thing.
I really like
for
me. How they did it.
Yeah, you too. Scary. Do you remember us trying to be like, is this the whole universe is blinking?
Just look like it's crazy and you don't understand anything.
Damn.
Woo! Okay.
I feel like it was never going to happen and here we are. Yeah. Oh, I love this. This is something that I'm so excited to see because it's so important in the book.
We actually had a pull on the set, so they really built a lot of this. And so they were actually carrying these rolled up, like gross, wrinkly sleeping bags with hair and throwing them into the pool that day.
The rehydrating, dehydrating. It's something that when people ask me about the shows, like everyone wants to talk about the dehydration, rehydration. So I think fans of the books are going to love these sequences. And Follower's so cute.
Follower's so good
as
well.
She's my favorite.
She's so good at acting.
So good.
Damn.
Save me. The way this was shot, he looks like a painting. Like, you're right. It's not quite real. It's like heightened visually.
Yeah. So it still has a sense of where are we?
Yeah.
Oh, Jess, you're so good in this.
Wow.
And then this was wild because then we had to leave and they would rebuild the same set but snowy. I came back from lunch one day and I saw a bunch of legs and arms sticking out of the snow and I went, wait, they're still under there, guys. Someone tell them they can get out.
It was the dummies.
It was the dummies. I was a dummy.
So I've never seen like 10,000 naked people freeze to death.
Neither
before.
Did I until we.
I'm from Manchester.
Only.
Come on. Saturday night.
我是这个世界的和平主义者，我首先收到信息是你们文明的幸运。
I'm a pacifist in this world. You're lucky that I'm the first to receive this message.
First contact.
First contact.
警告你们不要回答，如果回答，我们就会到来，你们的世界将被占领。
I'm warning you, don't answer.
What a message to receive.
Can you imagine?
Yes, we're out there, and for God's sake,
do not
talk to us again.
Why does she answer? Why do you answer? Why do we answer?
Why do you ruin everything?
Because that's an opportunity to change everything, right?
Yeah.
You know what? Yeah feels like a hero in this moment, I think. It's her opportunity to be a hero.
To change the world?
Yes, in her mind, to fix it.
Here we go.
I love that your finger.
What have you done?
I literally gasped when you pressed the button. Yeah.
How the press of a button can change the fate of the world. This is the announcement to the world of what's on the way.
When this happens,
Sofon has declared that war on us. You are bugs. This is when the message is displayed all over the world.
Rose's performance is so beautiful. Oh,
she's so incredible.
Look at Alex.
So the boys.
Here we go.
And
so this is a demonstration. You do have to remember that we know they are 400. It's 400 years for them to get here. Let me tell you something about this scene. There's very few productions, and I can't remember the last time it happened. They shut down Piccadilly Circus, one of the busiest areas in one of the largest cities on the planet. They shut it down.
This is so cool.
This is beautiful. It's just spectacular.
It's beautiful. The effects
and the way
team.
It bulges out of the mountain here is so. I'm super happy that they use this idea because when I was reading a book, my imagination about this scene would happen like, okay, different people see different thing.
Right.
See
interesting.
Were you guys up there or is that a stage as well?
No, we were up on the top of that roof.
Wow.
Yeah.
I love Marlo's reaction to this moment. I think her expression is so good.
She's wonderful in the show,
Isn't
Tatiana.
She
she's so good.
I love Marlo.
She's spooky. She's real spooky,
she's so
Tatiana.
Frightening. And in real life, quite the opposite.
Look at that mother god
Wonder
look.
In her eyes. Yeah.
She's a believer.
Oh, game.
This is Jack and Jin in the Kublai Khan era of the game.
Our computer has proven its worth. We've won.
I love how catty they are.
Yeah, they're horrible guys.
Yeah.
Boil them.
In these moments here where he's burning to death,
yeah,
I would get like really tearful.
I remember, and I was like, oh, he's going in.
Down my face, and then Andrew would be like, John, can you just duck your head under the water on action, then come up so you wipe all your tears away? And he's like, I've never been crying.
Why?
Because he watched a shot of me like coming up out of the water.
Yeah. Yeah.
So every single time my tears got wiped away.
Oh, for God's sake.
Unbelievable.
All in a line.
My moustache doesn't react well to being wet.
This is so cool.
And this is when we got under the harness.
I like that they kept a sense of a video game still.
This sequence is that it was directed by Andrew Stanton,
Pixar.
Who is an animator.
A legend.
He was able to paint these images in our mind very vividly.
That is spectacular.
This was a very scary scene.
So you're probably wondering where that hose has gone.
Oh, that part. Oh.
This is such an inventive sequence of how all the different ways they can illustrate this thing cutting everything in half.
Yeah.
Oh, and this shot of the kids. This
the kids.
And then the one kid doesn't run away. I'm like, dude, please run.
Don't be stupid.
Run!
And there's the wonderful Jonathan Pryce. He's so good in this. And Evans.
He's amazing.
This is great. Oh, remember this. Watch this. Look at that. I love those shots.
No, that was
of the,
amazing.
The paper,
foreshadowing.
Paper men.
This scene will forever, in my mind, be called Half Price. Hashtag Half Price.
Run, Jonathan!
It's absolutely astonishing, this sequence.
This is the scene I was most excited to see from page to screen.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah. Oh my God, it's horrific. It's difficult to watch, isn't it?
Yeah, it's very.
And it should be.
And then, so here's Jonathan running. Now, Jonathan and I had been talking in the dressing rooms about our knees. Because we both have to kneel down at some point.
Yes.
Shot. Look at him on his knees.
Yeah, with a broken ankle.
With a broken ankle.
Forgive me, my lord.
Oh, he's so good in this, isn't he?
Full discount.
Oh my God.
It's a great exit.
It's amazing.
I mean, if you want an exit, it's a great way to go out in pieces.
That's a good way to go.
Yes.
It is extraordinary.
This was a crazy scene to film, and it took longer than you would imagine. There was this horrible, scary movie that I was so traumatized
Ghost
growing
Ship.
Up with. Yeah, Ghost
yes,
Ship.
Yeah.
And this reminded, when I was reading it, I was like, oh, it's like Ghost Ship. And that's one of the most scarring scenes I'll ever have in my mind. So seeing this.
This is better than Ghost Ship, though.
This is.
Oh, Ghost Ship.
Remember
the
when they go like,
the little girl.
All the bodies?
Yeah, actually.
Judgment Day is gone. But this is a huge pivotal scene in the story. I mean, episode 5 is the biggest.
It's the blockbuster.
It's the biggest episode. Oh, that scene. That scene is going to scar a lot of people. I think it's going to be.
That episode is just going to be like.
Oh no.
This
oh no.
Is devastating.
Are you showing us
this?
No.
This makes me cry.
This scene, actually, interestingly, we had 3 goes at doing this scene. So as the scene as you watch it now, some of it was shot in April 22, some of it was shot in August 22, and some of it was shot in February 23.
Wow.
Just this one sequence from like now on. I can't tell you which bit was which.
Marlo's such a badass.
Thoroughly
shot. She is. She has such a scary look.
Yeah.
Like she's genuinely terrifying.
Yeah.
You said I was free to go.
You were?
All right, that's it. Get out of my house. Get off me.
Oh, man.
Our stunt coordinator, Rowley, was like, you can hit him as hard as you want, you know, he can take it.
Let's see.
I just so wanted to get this bit right, really. My job, when you find out you've only got 3 episodes, is and not a great amount of time to do it, you've just got to, by the end of it, make people care that he's gone and
totally.
Oh, you totally did.
We care. And then Karma Police.
It's a great.
Oh, this scene breaks my heart.
Oh, you're so tiny, I can't.
Once I'd read the scripts, this was always my favorite scene on the page. And it was quite late in production, so it was very exciting when we finally got to shooting it. But I also felt quite a lot of pressure because it's very pivotal for our relationship. Our director, Jeremy, we caught him sniffling in Video Village and we were like, all right, maybe we've done something right.
And he gave us a lot of freedom that day as well to build up to what it needed to be.
I can't imagine, because Alec took seriously, you know, embodying someone that is dealing with this terrible illness and just having to memorize your lines and do all that when you're starving and your body's in starvation mode, like that's a huge challenge.
For a year.
Yeah.
Real dedication.
Yeah, no, it was, yeah.
MVP.
And then for the first time ever, I get to say,
and I love you.
Aww.
Finally, he said it.
And she's like, oh shit, same.
This scene breaks my heart.
Look at that.
You're so good, Alex. You're so talented.
Thank you.
Look at you.
Aww. I get emotional just watching it again.
Aww, it's very sweet.
That's the first major cry moment for everyone.
This is right at the end of the episode 8, I think, isn't it? We've had a disaster. The plan has not worked. The staircase project.
We hope you're enjoying your flight, Mr. Wade.
And that voice.
Oh, you are so good in this. Oh my God.
Sophana showed up, which we're used to her being on a screen.
If your hibernation technology works.
And I'm used to seeing her in the game.
Yes, Liam, you're frightened. That's so odd.
Yeah, this is the first
only
time
you
get to see
you. To see you being vulnerable.
Yes, that's true, actually, yeah.
Yeah.
If you're watching me, I must be doing something right.
Oh, so sexy.
Yes.
It's true.
We want you to know there will be a place for you when we arrive.
Now, this is interesting, that sentence.
You are part of our plan.
You are part of our plan. So this, how weird is that, that this guy, his reason for living, is to try and destroy what's talking to him.
We'll always be with you. Every room you enter, we'll already be there waiting for you. Whatever we want you to see, you will see.
It's really interesting.
Until the day you die.
Goosebumps.
I might be in a bit of trouble.
Oh my God, still sexy?
With no eyes?
No, that wasn't
still got
very
it.
Sexy.
That's what I'm saying. The eyes gone, still got it.